Hello again. Welcome to another month's lessons. I say this every month, but it's what a joy it is to be on your screen. I can see how happy you are to be there. Oh, it's beautiful. Right. The start. It's a start of a new quarter. It's a start of a bit of a new season in your drumming. You've mastered a lot of the basics of playing the kit. We're starting off a new kind of season, really, with the second grade in your Guildhall book. A lot of the stuff we did, we went through the Rhythm Revolution book. We've been going through the first grade of this. It's time to get now into grade two. If you turn to page 10 of your Guildhall snare book, you'll recognise some of the notation already that we've done in previous months' lessons, okay, when we did the 6-8 grooves and we did the 6-8 fills. The 6-8 time signature should look pretty familiar to you. Okay. Again, just to recap over 6-8. Instead of 4-4, where there was 4 beats in the bar, in 6-8 we'll have 6 beats in the bar, and they're all worth eighth notes. They're all worth quavers. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, just like at the very start when we're playing through some exercises, these next couple of exercises aren't the most exciting ones in the world, but maybe wear a party hat or something as you're playing them, and it'll make it a bit more exciting for you. All right. So here we go. Getting back into 6-8 time. I'm going to start off with grade 2, exercise 1, playing on page 10. Again, that excellent machine that you bought to flip me backwards if you were left-handed. Maybe switch that machine on again if you're left-handed and kind of do the opposite of what I'm doing. I'll be leading with my right. Here we go. Starting with number one. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, Okay, second exercise from your second grade is we're going to do exercise two, which is on page 11. Two new things to watch out for. Just like in the 6/8 fills, we've got some ands. We're doubling up on some. So on some beats, instead of just the 1, 2, 3, ba 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 ba. If you look at number one of grade two, the first bar will be played like this: 1, 2, and 3, 4. 1, 2, and 3, 4. So your left hand's coming into play a lot more there. So really follow the sticking closely on this exercise. Similarly to the way we did our 6/8 fills a couple of months ago. Other thing to watch out for, getting back to our note values, if you have a look at number two, okay, grade two, exercise two, number two, the second one down, if you look at the second bar, we've got two dotted notes there, okay? We're in 6/8 time, and a dotted note means that that note is lasting time and a half, okay? So the first crotchet there, in 6/8 time, a crotchet would be worth two beats, okay? Because it's dotted, it's worth three beats. So that crotchet will last for the first three beats of the bar. In the second bar there, and the second crotchet will last for the four, five, and six, the second lot of three beats in the bar. Okay, so watch out for those dotted notes as well. Okay, here we go. Grade 2, exercise 2. Number 1. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 3. 6. 5, 6. 5, 6. Number 4. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so in order to unlock what's coming next, please spend time with that. Please spend time going through that. If you need to wear a party hat to make it look exciting, please do. Please feel free to wear whatever hat you want if it makes it more exciting for you. But please do spend time with that. Okay, we'll be coming back to that in the coming months. What I really want to do with you this session is I want to do a bit of consolidation with you. And pull together really everything that we've been doing and put it under the banner of dynamic. A lot of things I'm going to be talking about in the future and in the coming months in the lessons, I'm going to be talking about this thing called dynamic all the time. Because for me as a drummer, the most important thing, whether you're playing rock, whether you're playing gospel, whether you're playing jazz, whether you're in a speed metal band, is that you have to create dynamic within the song, and that you have to do as a drummer what the song requires you to do in order for the song to go to the places it needs to go. To demonstrate that, I'm going to play a song that I think we played in one of the earlier weeks, the old Nirvana track, Teen Spirit. I'm going to play it in time, right? I'm going to play along with the song, I'm going to play it in time, then I'm going to pick it apart and show you the difference and show you that playing drums and using the beats you've already learned, it's so much more than just playing in time. Check this out. Here we go. So I'm playing it this time. I'm going to play it in time. Really listen to what the music's doing. The music's dropped for the verse. Still going on. Music starts to build. Chorus coming up. Here we go, big chorus. Okay, you get the idea that I'm trying to get across. What I played there, I played the song in time, but it didn't do anything. Maybe in lessons 3 or lessons 4, that was good enough because that's where we were then. But now, just simply doing that isn't good enough. The chorus didn't lift. Nothing happened there. I'll play the track again. Here we go. Dynamic, dynamic. We'll be right back. the start of the track, lifted it. Bass drum now, playing along with what the bass is doing. Boom, 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 boom. Now, I'm opening the hats to hint at the chorus. Chorus is coming up. Big fill into the chorus. Songs dipped. Bass drum locking into what the bass is doing. Okay, so some of the main differences there. At the start of the track, I played a big fill to bring the song in. Once the song was in, the song dictated that the drums were big, all right? Instead of riding along on the ride cymbal, I was riding on the crash cymbal. We talked a while ago about you can use anything to groove on, okay? You can groove on the hats. You can groove on a music stand. You can groove on whatever you want, man. That song, grooving on the crash cymbal, really, really lifts it. Back down to the hats for the verse. When the pre-chorus was coming in, I opened the hats, and what that did was it just gave you an idea that the song was going somewhere, okay? And then nailed a big fill. I think there's only like three fills in the whole song, but when the fills hit, you have to follow the fill with something bigger. There's no good playing along with the bass. And going back to there, what we did that time. Then went on to riding on the crash cymbal again. If you nail your fill in, drummers, you must go somewhere else that's bigger. You must. And then dropping it down again for the second verse. Okay, this time I'm actually going to play the song all the way through. I'm gonna really nail those different transitions. I'm also going to add something, which is the challenge I'm going to leave you with. Last month, we went over the straight snare, went over the straight snare groove. If you haven't downloaded the sheet yet, go onto the website and download the sheet. We were going one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. We demonstrated that with the police track message in a bottle, but also in the context of a song like this, I'm going to save that groove till right near the very end. And what it's going to do is, it's going to take the song. Just when you think the song can't get any higher, we're going to play that song to end it all. Okay, here we go. Dynamic.
great snares are going to come in just when you need to lift the song more. Bring those great snares in. Here we go.
The things I've talked about in that song, about the fills, about the dynamic, the importance of dynamic at all times, applying what we've learned so far to that principle of dynamic and applying everything that we're going to learn in the future to this principle of dynamic, I'll be talking about it loads in the future. So have fun with that this month. See you soon.